You've been asking me so many questions and posting so many comments, and I'm so grateful, and I want to be able to answer every single one of them, and I'm trying. In this video, I've gathered a few questions that relate to consular processing, embassies, and things like that. I'm going to try to answer them in video format. If you like that, I'm going to make more of these videos and choose other topics. So once again, don't stop commenting, don't stop asking questions. I'm going to make videos answering those questions. So let's jump right in. I'm super excited to make this video because in this video, I get to answer your questions as you ask them, as you post them in the comments. And if you like this format, I'll be doing those videos more and more. This time I chose the theme of US embassies, consulates, and questions that are related to NVCs, K-1s, and all the good stuff. So let's jump right into your questions. Question from Neil Hussein: how to email NVC? Can you make a video about it? So that's a great question, and we see a lot of these comments, and I think that's why I chose this comment, because it's very common for people to want to know how to contact the NVC. So remember, once your I-130 is approved, the family petition is approved, the case is then transferred to the National Visa Center for further processing. At that point, they're going to ask you to fill the DS-260, ask for all the supporting documents, and it's really important to stay in touch with them. So how do we communicate with them? So one way is to send an email inquiry to the NVC, and the email address is right here on the screen, nvcinquiry@state.gov, just right here. That's the best way to send them an email and to make an inquiry about your case. Please do not abuse that email because they get so many emails and so many questions. Another way is to use the phone number, and the phone number is right here on the screen, 603-334-0700. So those are the best two ways to communicate with NVC. If you have questions about your case or you're confused about any of the forms or anything that you have to do, you email them to nvcinquiry@state.gov or you call that phone number right here on the screen. We're also going to put a link in the description of this video to the phone number and to the email, so you don't have to worry about it if you missed it right now. The next question is from Felice Vlong, and the question is as following: is priority date or when they approve date is when they're going to consider for the interview? My priority date was January 2020. Please reply. So that's a great question. In family-based petitions, the priority date of the I-130 in this case is the date when the Immigration Service receives your case. So for example, when the case is received, that's when your priority date is determined. In your case, it was January 2020, is when your case was received, and that's also your priority date. Now, the approval date may be months in the future, 7-8 months in the future, that's when the I-130 is approved, but that's not the priority date. The priority date is when they receive the case, that's when you get the priority date, and you have to check it on the visa bulletin every month, and when your priority date is current, that's when you can proceed with the adjustment of status if you're in the US, or with your immigrant visa petition if you're outside the country. It's a very common question for people to get confused, so it's not when the I-130 is approved, it's the date immigration receive your case. The next question is from Sadaf Nouri. The question is, hi Jacob, can you please tell me how can I expedite my husband's case? I'm a green card holder and my husband is waiting for his interview. He's in Afghanistan. So that's a great question. So first of all, we've done quite a few videos about how to expedite a case. In fact, we have a very recent success story. You can see the link in the cards here in this video. But remember, you are just a green card holder. This is the F2A category. And as you know, currently, under the proclamation, those categories are not able to proceed and get interviews because the proclamation bans the entry of spouses of green card holders. If you were a US citizen, and even US citizens right now, their cases are stuck because embassies are not really open, and therefore the right way to expedite is to file a request with the National Visa Center for an expedited case with the correct reasons under national interest exceptions. And then once they approve it, then we can request an emergency appointment at the US Embassy. But in your case, because you're a green card holder, the embassy will not give you a priority because under the proclamation, you're not able to process that case. So right now you have to wait a few more weeks until the end of September, and then we'll see what happens. And hopefully by then, cases will start moving much faster than now. Hopefully this helps. Let me know in the comments. The next question is for Naina Mangar. Hi sir, how about K-1 fiancé visas taking so long right now? So that's a great question, and we've done quite a few videos about K-1 visas. The situation right now is that, first of all, we're still waiting on litigation There are more than 500 couples that filed a lawsuit because of the delays and because of the family separation. We still don't have any information on that, and so we're waiting for it. But the reality is that a lot of embassies are still not giving priority to K-1 visas. And the thing is, there was an announcement by State Department a few months ago that they will be giving priority. They also said that K-1 visas, they will expire the validity, they'll be able to renew them without reapplying for the case from the beginning. So validities will be extended automatically. But remember that if you are a K-1 visa holder and you think that you have a good exception to try to expedite your case, right now my suggestion is to try to expedite your case by working with NVC and the embassy to see if you fit any of the exceptions to be able to move your case even further. But aside from that, there's really not much that the fiancés can do right now, because unless the embassies are going to reopen for routine processing, a lot of these K-1 visas are stuck and they're waiting. What we have done in our office, we try to file a lot of these expedited cases, and we had a lot of success to be able to fit in people into the national interest exceptions, and it still works. It's worth a shot to try, because right now the backlogs are really severe, and I feel really bad for these families that are being separated for no reason. So once again, not too many updates about K-1. As soon as I know about the litigation, hopefully if that will be successful, embassies will be forced to give more priority to K-1 visas, and hopefully we'll start pushing those through faster than they do now. So hopefully that answers your question. I know a lot of you guys are worried about K-1s. Let's see what we can do about this in the future. Here's a comment from Akua Niarku. Embassies will start appointments when Biden will take over in January. What this current administration have done is pure torture, and there's no excuse for that. So it's not really a question, it's a comment, but a lot of people are wondering what's gonna happen when Biden's gonna take over in January as to what's going with the embassies. What we know, what we think is gonna happen is that this new administration is gonna move towards adjudications rather than enforcement, which means that it's gonna force the embassies hopefully to start pushing cases out, NVC to start sending cases for appointments. And instead of blocking people from coming in, they're gonna actually allow people to enter and start issuing more visas. Again, it's gonna take some time. It's not gonna be immediate. I think within 6 months probably, we'll see a more flow of movement. But the damage that this administration has caused the US embassies and NVC is gonna take some time to reverse. That's my personal opinion. Here's the last question from Sonia Shibu. We are F4 category, interview scheduled on 16th of March, Bombay canceled, please update. So it's a good question, it will apply to not just F4 sibling category, but all categories. Currently, the US Embassy in Mumbai is closed for routine appointments. We have a lot of people that are inquiring about Mumbai. We're hoping that sometime in January, maybe beginning of February, they will open for routine appointments, but for the moment, no. Remember, those people that were rescheduled in February, in March, in April, should be getting priority to be scheduled for new interviews as they start these new appointments. So if you were rescheduled in March, we're hoping that you will get a priority for your case to be rescheduled again as they resume routine processing, sometime probably late January, maybe beginning of February, hopefully sooner. But the good news is those people that were rescheduled, already had appointments scheduled, but then rescheduled, should be first priority to get their new appointments as they reopen the embassies. And that is the right thing on part of the embassies to process, and we hope it's gonna happen. There you have it, guys. These are some of the answers to some of your most burning questions. I'm gonna make a few of these segments again if you like it. Let me know in the comments if you like this format and what other questions you have, and I'll make a batch of more questions. I'll make another video, and who knows, maybe you'll be featured in the next video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. One more thing. In some of those questions, I talked about K-1 visas and how to expedite. Watch this video with more information about K-1 visas and expedited, just to help you understand more how this process works. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.